happy holidays from the Sharps and Flats. To help celebrate with you, we put together some patriotic and inspirational songs recorded live from Piner Hall and Robinson Hall. We hope you will sing along with us. We're going to begin with a song by George M. Cohan, "You're a Grand Old Flag," with choreography by Stephen Dunn.
I have a personal connection to America the Beautiful. Catherine Lee Bates wrote the anthem in 1893. She lived in Falmouth, Massachusetts on Cape Cod. I spent a lot of time in the beautiful old house where Bates was born and raised. Her father was the minister of the church on the village green, where I played the pipe organ for 30 years. The lyrics of this patriotic song were inspired by her trips around the country. She saw Purple Mountain's majesty at the top of Pike's Peak. And in Chicago, the tall white buildings with their new electric lights looked like an alabaster city gleaming. My church considers this song to be our hymn, and we sing it for every holiday, funeral, and special event.
Oh. Music was one of the many things that provided entertainment, distraction, and enjoyment to the American troops, both overseas and at home. It also helped uplift those still on the home front and helped separated families feel more connected through music. Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy by the Andrews Sisters became an iconic song of World War II.
Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was the top man of his craft. And then his number came up and he was gone with the draft. He's in the army now, a blowing reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. They made him blow a bugle for his Uncle Sam. They really got him down because he could not jam. The captain seemed to understand. Because the next day the cap went out and drafted a band. And now the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B.
In 1918, and then revised the lyrics in 1938. Kate Smith recorded that version of the song, and it was heard on the radio every week for more than 2 years. Berlin sold more than 500,000 copies of the sheet music in 1939 alone.
Thank you. God Bless America, which we just sang, was the inspiration for our next song. In 1940, Woody Guthrie wrote, "This Land Is Your Land," as a response to Irving Berlin's anthem, God Bless America. Berlin's song was, in a sense, the big picture, placing the country above its grateful people. Guthrie's song puts people first. This land belongs to you and to me. Over time, this popular song has been sung by Pete Seeger and Bruce Springsteen. Beautifully rendered by the Mormon Tabernacle Choir, it has also found a place around countless campfires and on hiking trails throughout this magnificent country.
On patriotic holidays, we are also reminded that God is in control of all aspects of His creation, and that we should take comfort in His presence. He's got the whole world in His hands is a traditional African-American spiritual, first published in 1927. It became an international pop hit in 1957, and has been recorded by countless singers and choirs.
The whole world The song, "When the Saints Go Marching In," originated as a 19th century Protestant hymn and remains a message of revelation and redemption. In 1939, Louis Armstrong transformed the spiritual into the jazz tune that we know and love today. There are many songs that have been written about the beautiful states and cities in the United States of America. "Carolina in the Morning" was written in 1922, but is it about North Carolina or South Carolina? Well, even Google can't tell us that for sure. But in my 100-year history, I'm betting on North Carolina.
John Denver's "Take Me Home, Country Roads" has become synonymous with West Virginia all over the world, and the phrase "almost heaven" has become the state's marketing slogan. But the song also evokes memories for any of us who have traveled beautiful and picturesque country roads in any state.
West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, blowing like a breeze. Country road, take me home.
her. Miner's lady, stranger to blue water. Dark and dusty, painted on the sky. Misty taste of moonshine, teardrops in my eyes. Country road. The radio reminds me of my home far away. Driving down the road, I get a feeling that I should have been home yesterday. Yesterday.
New York, New York is one of the most popular songs ever written about the Big Apple. But who was the first person to record it? Was it Frank Sinatra or Liza Minnelli? If you guessed Old Blue Eyes, you're wrong. Liza Minnelli actually recorded the song 2 years before Sinatra. The song also coined the well-known nickname for New York as the city that never sleeps.
Let There Be Peace on Earth is a musical example of the harmony we strive for every day in our world. Friendship and love know no bounds, and this understanding is an origin of peace. And it all begins with you and me.
There. Yankee Doodle Dandy is a 1942 biographical American film about George M. Cohan, who was known as the man who created Broadway. The film starred James Cagney as Cohan. What you may not know is that Fred Astaire was originally offered the title role. He turned it down, primarily because Cohan's eccentric, stiff-legged dancing was so very different from Astaire's fluid, graceful dancing style. James Cagney won the Oscar for Best Actor for his role in the film.
Our last song has become our Sharps and Flats theme song. It's not a patriotic song, but one that reminds us of the power of singing together and how music can build bridges of understanding and harmony anywhere in the world. We hope you have a wonderful holiday. And we look forward to having live concerts again soon.